If you see me ride by, holla at your boy. I got more swag, holla at your boy. Yeah. You guys are watching Campus 101 with yours truly, the Campus King Africa, MC Casmil. Now, you can also follow me up on social media. It's just MC Casmil. Instagram, Facebook, Twitter, and the rest. Of course, speaking about our second part of the show, I have more entertainment coming up for you. I went and checked out some hostel cribs, you know. I've started going through your hostels and check you guys out and see how you're living life. How's your lifestyle in hostels? How's your life in halls of residence? I don't know about your work. You never know. You might feel free to please invite me at your home. As long as you're a student, I will always come through and see how you manage to commute from home up to campus every day and how much you even spend on that. Is it terrifying for you? Is it okay with you and all that? But for now, let's go to one of those hostels at Mumbs Nakau and check out how these guys live life at hostel.
Hi, I'm Alan, a student of Mumbs. Welcome to my room. I'm offering BCom or doing BCom. And this is actually my shelf for my books. I do some reading very often, so I'm really into reading as well as a student. Being a student, I really have to take on my responsibilities. Yeah, then this is my closet. As you can see, everything is really so organized. This is my bag, my school bag, the one I use for my books. Then I really love doing gentle things. I do so much of gentle, like as you can see the shirts. They are gentle shirts. I do them Monday to Friday. Yeah, then this is my show for the shoes. These ones, they are for the weekend. Then being a gentle guy, this is all I do for the whole weekdays. This is my friend.
Hey, I'm Cindy.
This is my other friend.
Hi, I'm Edna.
I was right here taking you through my bed and stuff. This is my bed. Then this is my roommate's bed. He's actually outside. Meanwhile, this is our seat area. When we have friends around, they can use these seats when they're around over the weekend when we are really so free. We can take up that space for our space area. This is our washroom, our toilet. Then this is our sink where we do the cleaning and stuff. Plates, utensils, all those other things. Then these are the utensils, cups. Then down here is where we keep our food. As you can see, this is the commonest meal everywhere. This is what almost every student does. They are kept right here. Everything is really packed in here. From our plate area, we have our entertainment place. This is a Hisense screen. It's 550. We do some movies and stuff, so we really love watching. That's why I had to get it. Then this is a PS4. As you can see, there is already a game that was already playing. So this is our PS4. We got it at 950. Then this is our sound system. For those that really love music, they're also placed right here. Then these are our PCs for our school study.
All right, I've been delighted to be invited here by Conrad and Alan in their room. And of course, he just gave you a tour around. I hope you guys loved it. But first things first, let me get to know them in detail because this is my first time to meet them and they're new friends to me. How you doing?
Yeah, I'm doing well. I'm doing fine.
Okay, introduce yourself again.
Yeah, I'm Conrad doing BCom second year.
Second year? Mobs. All right.
Yeah, I'm Alan doing BCom second year.
Okay. And of course, we also have some friends of Alan and Conrad in the house, so we're very delighted. It's a big team, yeah? How you doing?
I'm okay, hi.
What's your name?
I'm Chloe.
Chloe?
Yeah, doing accounting, second year.
Second year?
Almost, yeah.
You've been so close to Alan. Are you the girlfriend or something of a sort?
No, he's my bro. He's my
really?
Brother. Yeah.
Like real brother?
Yeah, yeah.
Alan, is she your sister, really?
Yeah, right now she's like my sister. She's always around.
Oh, in other words, sister in Christ, yeah, but not
yeah.
real sister.
Yeah, sure.
And, I love hostel life. How you doing?
I'm doing good.
Okay, what's your name?
My name is Edna.
Edna.
I'm doing BBA, first year.
First year. Mm. And the lady who's been hiding in that side, how you doing?
I'm fine. I'm Cindy, doing BBA, first year.
First year.
Yeah.
All right. And finally, gentlemen.
I'm Cyrus.
Cyrus, eh?
Yeah.
What is the most expensive thing in this room?
Well, I think it's the Pasa, because it's a PS4 Pro. Mm. It goes like 1.2.
1.2?
Yeah.
When did you buy it?
I think in August, beginning first year. Hey. Last year.
Okay, yeah. Now you guys that you have your roommates, so who contributed 60% and 40%?
Like 50-50.
50-50?
Yeah.
Wow, quite price. Amazing.
Yeah.
And I was wondering, you know, Alan was taking us around. I wondered why cooking oil was in the sound system. What happened?
Like, really cool, okay? So, like, just hide them behind that side. Because really, do the cooking. Girls come around, they do the cooking, then that's all. Yeah.
How can you have all these girls come to your room and then when you find cooking oil in the sound system? Eh? But anyway, away from that, I know I'm very delighted. Why did you decide to be in a... this is a double? Yeah. Why did you decide to be in a double room?
First, Conrad has been my boy, my everything, my brother. So when an opportunity turned up for us to be one again, I had to really take it up, because sometimes being in a single room comes with its own challenges. You may be sick, maybe late in the night, you've gotten and maybe attacked.
Yeah, yeah.
No one can come to rescue or to yourself in the room.
Yeah, yeah.
So literally you need to have someone next to you at all the time.
Yeah.
So that's why I had to like take up the opportunity when it came up for us to share a room, because
yeah, yeah.
we have known each other for a really long time.
One thing I've been told about people staying in double rooms, I'll tell you my people, there is something they call climbing trees. I need to clarify, what does it mean really?
Well, climbing a tree is like when like my boy Alan like brings a girl around, yeah, so like I've given space, so I have to climb a tree. That's the climbing.
How many trees do you climb per week?
I think 3 trees a week.
How about you, man? How many do you climb in a week?
5 times a week.
So otherwise, this is like the free day. I'm very lucky that I came on a free day. Yeah? All right. Do even girls also climb trees? I need to find out. Do girls also climb trees?
We don't.
You don't?
We don't.
How do you handle? You never get visited by a, you know, boyfriend or...
No, we get visited by friends and all, and yeah, it's all cool.
Oma, tell me the truth. You have never climbed a tree for her?
They're not really trees, but yeah.
That automatically shows you that there is something, maybe. Okay, that has already showed me a yes for me. All right, funny guys, as you know, I'm very glad to be back in your rooms. And, you know, we do this on Campus 101. If you're watching the show across all universities and everywhere you're catching the show from. Speaking about Campus Cribs, I have a lot for you guys. And so every week I'll try my best to make sure that I bring you on Campus Crib, because it's one of those segments you people who watch the show each and every Saturday, 11 a.m., enjoy so much. So make sure every Saturday you're hooked on the show and watch out how guys live life in hostels, halls of residence, and even those who are commuting. And nevertheless, right about now, ladies and gentlemen, without further ado, it's about that time we switch to another segment called Campus Juice. But before we check out the Lugambo that has been making news here and the biggest stories of the week, you know, in a few weeks from now, we're going to be celebrating World AIDS Day. And today I want to take this special moment and talk to people and find out if they have really tested, because it so happens that according to the research that has been proven in 2019, people no longer want to use condoms, people no longer go for HIV tests. Have you tested yet? Let's check out what people have to say.
2 weeks ago.
All right. Have you tested for HIV, and when did you last test, if so?
I've never tested. No.
Like in your whole life you've never tested for HIV?
No, never.
Why?
I'm not sexually active, never been sexually active, so there's no point in me doing it.
When did you last test for HIV?
Last year.
I last tested, I think, last year.
I last did my HIV test at the beginning of the year.
Okay. I last tested last month, the other month. That was, yes, last month.
In other news, I have a good friend of mine called Olo, one of the hottest TV presenters of this generation. He has been doing something across campuses, Silent Disco tours. We've been at Chambogo University, we've been at MOBS, at specifically Akamwesi, we've been at Ndeje. And guess what? Next Friday, there's something happening huge here at IUA. It's going to be the IUA edition for the Silent Disco Olo experience. And I hooked up with him earlier on for a press conference to find out what we should expect on this IUA edition that is going to be happening next Friday. Is it going to be the last one we're seeing this year? Are we having more this year before it ends, and so much more? So let's find out what he had to say and how his press conference went down when it comes to these campus situations. Silent discos.
Yo, IUA, we wagendo kubera disco. Ate DJ gwenzize na ye, ye El Nico. Gamba chari wa gambe kwa li boss kombo tuli wanuku. IUA wetu kuba silent disco.
How's it going? How's it going?
Everything well, man. What's good, man?
Yeah, let's talk about Silent Disco. Yeah. What's happening? It's the plot for all campuses coming up next Friday.
Yep.
In brief, from the press, what can you tell the people? What should we expect from this edition?
It's going to be an international episode, man. Yeah, yeah. Everything is international. You haven't seen this before.
Yeah.
We're going to party in the silence. Yeah, it's going to be silent mode throughout. Yeah. But when you're feeling the vibe, from the moment you enter this entire IUA,
yeah, yeah,
it's going to be a crazy, crazy place.
All right, my people, let's talk about the biggest stories that, you know, have been trending when it comes to campus entertainment. One of them is Mr. and Miss Kumba University. It happened last Friday. Luckily enough, I was one of the judges, and it was a very awesome and impressive event, I should say. Big up to everybody, all the organizers from Kumba University. And speaking about the event, it ended at 2 a.m. Bebe Cool performed. We had so many people contesting. When it comes to the girls, we had literally over, was it around 8-9 of them contested, and also had like around 5 boys, which is quite amazing because at least to some universities, they don't even have the event called Mr. and Miss. But nevertheless, I want to say congrats to Bob and Maria. They are the new king and queen of the university. And guess what? You guys will see the entire action of what happened down at Nkumba University next week in our next episode. Just keep it locked. Speaking about the question I asked you last week on the show, what should be done? What's the solution to stop these tuition increment policies that keep happening in universities every year, in specific Makerere University? You have seen what has been happening in Makerere lately, the strikes, students have been arrested, tortured, and all that because of tuition increment policy, the 15% of what was impacted on students. And I went on social media to ask you guys what should be done. Let me find out what you had to say when it comes to feedback. Karamaji Frederick says, so long as there is inflation, increased cost of living, salary increase demands by staff, etc., there will be tuition increment always. All right? Then Mark Gerard says, surely there should be a law or a committee responsible for setting school fee structures for all schools and universities. Jonathan says, nothing much should be done. It's better we just mind our own business. Come on. Come on, Jonah, man. Why would you say that, bro? We're now contributing towards this topic, and everybody who made sure that you go on social media to answer and give us some solutions of what you think should be done. Thank you very much. The page is Urban Television. That is where we ask all the questions every week. And our personal page for the show is called Campus 101-Official. So my question I have for you this week is, which campus in Uganda has the hottest girls? Honestly, I need an honest answer. Don't say something because you're from a specific university. I repeat the question, which campus has the hottest girls, has the hottest booties when it comes to universities in Uganda? Go on social media, Urban Television, answer that question, and next week I'll be getting feedback and find out which university has more ratings when it comes to beautiful ladies. Yeah, yeah. But for now, to say goodbye, ladies and gentlemen, until we meet again next week on Saturday, 11 a.m. And then YouTube, it's hashtag Campus101 to watch all our previous episodes, including this one. May God bless you and bless us too. But for now, I'm going to leave you with Wall of Fame. Check out who we have. Yeah, yeah.
I think you fell in love too fast. African nights and a cool rush. And I remember you refused to kiss me, and now you're using my toothbrush. You say you think I talk too much, that
don't like the high.